Hello and welcome to Magzie's Fun Time. This is Magzie, and we are back here on Affinity Evolved Skyblock. not much time has passed. I spent a little bit of time over here. This is exactly 12 hours before last episode, so I haven't got to do hardly anything. But I did get another 10-10-10 crop, so I've got beans, melons, pumpkins, and I hopefully hear dandelions, which I will be working on off camera here. Actually, I need to scan that one real quick. And see, every time you scan a seed, regardless of whether you think it's 10-10-10 or not, it will give you some information about what kind of things can be bred with it. And I put some more of these little drawers over here because I figured some of these little drawers will be good for like little stuff that I'm not going to have like tons of, like cactus or beans or something like that. And then my main stuff's going to be over here. This is going to be gone. I'm not going to keep that over here. Today we are going to set up the little area off of here with animals in mind. I don't know if I'm going to keep it all separate or just one big fence. I haven't decided yet. And we're going to do the fish thing. And first things first, I want to show you guys. Hold on, one more thing. One more thing I did off camera. Looky, looky. Singular. Lumium. So, by next episode, we will be able to set this lava up to where it auto. We'll be able to switch over to the thermal expansion pipes. That means we will need some of the thermal expansion what are they called? I'm gonna have to look it up now. These things. Filters. Whoa, what? Aw, oh, dude. Hold on. Okay. So, I might have accidentally put this big platform over here and then forgot to light it up. Maybe. Just maybe. Alright, so let's go deal with this real quick. I totally forgot about this. The reason this is not lit up is because I only built this so I could put these, cobblestone underneath here for the stuff that had sand. And I did mistakenly put a couple here instead of here, but it'll be alright. It'll be alright. And we needed to get to this area anyway. So I'm going to have to come out a little bit more. But now that the excitement's over with, I did move all of my gears and stuff down here. I still got some more parts on it. I did make some steel rods to make the builder's wand. If you guys don't know how to make it, it is two diamond blocks and then two steel rods. And steel rods are just made from one steel ingot above the other one in the crafting gate, and that gives you four, which means I had two left over. And I don't really know if those are actually used for anything else. No uses. The rod thing. Fence posts. And the builder's wrong. Okay. So I will need those. So I might make a little bit more. However, let's get on to today. I know that you guys are wondering now, how do I get slime? there's some stuff that I need to do. Like if I want to move these downstairs, I either need slime or I need to get the dolly, which is like super hard to make. If you haven't seen the dolly recipe, let me show you that real quick. This is the dolly. You need a jobber barrel, two wedge pressure plates, and this. These are reinforced wheels. The reinforced wheels is iron around a reinforced metal. The reinforced metal is made by smelting down stable metal, which is iron, hardened mash, and refined hardeners. The hardened mash is more refined hardeners around iron bars. And refined hardeners are raw hardeners, which is a four obsidian around a diamond. Which, so before I even get to Dolly, I'm going to set up my auto. Auto obsidian. We're going to use thermal expansion for that one because it's the easiest way to set up auto obsidian. But before I do that, I want to get away from this lava power over here, and I don't think this is going to cut it. And we have to do a reactor anyway, so I'm going to do some research, and we're probably going to set up a reactor, which means I'm going to need the thermal centrifuge. Which means I'm going to have to make a mining laser. So I'm going to make all of that stuff. Why are you still spawning up there? It boggles my mind. Hold on, let me eat real quick. Let's take care of this creeper. And I might make me a weapon this episode. I'm kind of tired of not having one. Come on, Mr. Creeper. Come on. Are you not going to... You're not going to come out and play? You're going to make me stack up there, aren't you? Come on. Now you must have despawned. Okay, whatever. Let's go ahead while we're over here and take these guys out. It's kind of relevant to what we're doing today. So, before you get slimed, or before you get... Let's start out at the beginning. Slime is originated with several things, alright? So, one of the things that slimes are originated with is Khajiit blood. And there's a way to make... Well, there used to be a way to make Khajiit blood where you did it with a smeltery... And you smelt it down, rotten flesh. Or you could, like, put stuff in there, animals and stuff, and it would get, you could actually stand in there and get some blood yourself. Let's get this F7 off, so it doesn't bug you guys. Anyway, hold up. Before we go anywhere else, I am going to put another... And if... I'm going to get up there and put some half-labs up there off camera. So, in this pack, it's slightly different. So, I'm going to show you guys how to make Khajiit blood. Now, the first thing you're going to need is you're going to need some smooth sandstone. Alright, let me put... the rest of this up in here, and ooh, we got four guys. I'm so excited about this because we can make enderium if we go here. And go to uses. Come on. We need shiny, tin, and silver. We need one shiny, two tin, one silver, and that will give us about four, five. But that'll get us started. That'll get us started with that. So that's the last special material that I need, and it requires grinding out those things over there, which we're going to get grinded for, which is why we wanted a vat this episode also. I do want to get the vat at least made. Show you guys how to make it. Anyway. So. First thing we need is... I'm trashing these for now. I'm going to put these in over here. Sorry about that, guys. I about sneezed on you guys. I'm gonna put these over here somewhere as soon as I empty some more spots out. But for right now, I'm just trashing them. And I got Enderman head and some more unstable fire protection. I'm gonna save most of these because I'm gonna try to get the enchantments off here if I can. I don't need a bow. Come on, get the heck out of here. We get the string off of there, and the head. We'll go ahead and put the head in here. So we're gonna collect heads. Okay, so now after that, you're gonna need some rotten flesh. And what you do to start out with is you put the smooth stone in here and you put the rotten flesh in here. Hold on. Uses. It's 4. Okay. Like that. And I'll do like that. There we go. And that gives you these bloodstained blocks. And if we go to uses on bloodstained blocks, there's some, I don't know. You can make cool stuff with them. You make creeper eyes. You make brick ones. Okay. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to make sure both of these are on. Cutting off the thing, okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to stick them in here. And as you can see, those are smelting down. And when they smelt completely down, you get blood. Let me take this out of there. Now that you have blood in here, you can right click and it'll pour some of the blood out. It's 160 and it gives you some cajilled blood. Cajilled blood. And that's how you get it. And you can use these for slimes. Alright? Anything you could use slimes for, you can use these for. So as you see, leads. The water tank, which is really, really awesome. I might be able to show you guys what that does. We might build that. It's super cheap, and it's another way to get water. So it'll be a good thing to show you guys. Lines. Some other stuff. Name tags, if you want to. Your stickers that you need for your Java barrels. Dry sponges. Bioreactor, you can use congealed blood instead of slimes. So just about anything. Safari nets. Come on, you guys know. And this, the packing tape, which is going to help us move. Also, sticky pistons. The packing tape's going to help us move those downstairs. So, anyway, how much we got more in here? 80. Almost. I don't know if I have enough. I might have to smelt one more. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to have to smelt more when we get the rest of that there. But I'll handle that later. So now we have this. And I want to go downstairs real quick. And we're going to grab some iron. And I'm going to build this and I'm going to take it down because I want to put it over here. Behind this thing right here, and I'm going to connect it directly up to this thing. So I'm going to build it a little bit out, a little bit, and we're going to directly connect it with a water, one of these things right here, to this. So that will fill this up, which will in turn fill this up. So we'll automatically get. Now we could just build it on top, but I don't know if blocking this is going to keep it from gathering water. I still want to gather water even with this the passive thing we got on here. So I'm going to build it just a little bit behind and just connect it to it with a pipe. Okay, so we need a little bit more wood. Grab some wood. And then if we go to uses here and look this up again. Come on, where you at? There you are. And it's 3x3x3, so we need 28. There we go. Okay, now this is from Railcraft. And basically what you do is you build this. Should we go ahead and put it out there? Can I get out behind here? I've got some cobble on me. And we have the builder's wand, so it should be really, really simple to just... Why are you not working? That's weird. Okay, I guess we'll do it manually. Maybe because it was half slabs? Yeah, that was it. So, I want to leave a space in between it, so there we go. And definitely put one there and one there. No, we can't do that. We'll put one in between here like that. And then you just build this in a 3x3. And I don't believe you leave it hollow. There we go. And when it completes, stop that. You'll be able to click on it, I believe. What the heck? Guess not. Maybe it is hollow. Hold on. We'll see. There we go. And as you see, it will gain water on its own. The water it gains is based off of your... The humidity level in the biome that you're actually in. Since we're in deep ocean, it should do pretty good here. And it'll just passively gain water on its own. Without, you don't even need rain. Pretty sweet. And it's pretty cheap, too. So let's put the rest of these up. We don't need those. Let's get that off there so it doesn't give you guys a headache. We need some more. 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to try to get that out of there. I need more than that. I did hook these up with... Oh, I didn't show you guys that. The nullification upgrade. Basically, it keeps a stack in here and then voids the rest of them. So, if you need... sand... in a hurry... you can get some there. I'm going to need some more of this, so I'm going to make some more. But for right now, I just need one more, I think. This should give us 100, right? We'll see. There's 80 in there right now. And this is super fast. I love using Blazing Promethium. Yep, 180. And she gives one more. Here we go. I'm going to go ahead and put... this all in here. I'm gonna put you back in here. Okay, the next thing we need is our fishing. So let's look at this. I'll take you out of here real quick. We'll put the congealed blood. And I also want to put you back up. I thought I put you up. What the heck? I put the planks in there instead. Goofy. Okay, so what we're going to be making is the fish trap. And it is from Pam's Harvest Craft. Really simple to make. 3 string, a chest, a fishing rod, and 4 sticks. So we'll get us 3 string. 2, 3. We need two more string for the fishing rod. And we'll got some stuff for the sticks. So, if we do this, there's a chest. I got some chests over there in storage. I need to start using those. And then the sticks. And then the fishing rod. And then if we just click this, it won't go because of the fishing rod. Chest. Three string. And that gives us the fishing trap. Alright. We'll bring the fishing trap over here to where our... we have our water thing. It should work in here. We can just drop down right here. And we can just put this on the bottom here. Get out. Where's my... I don't have time to mess with you guys. Come on. Move out of my way. There we go. This is a little oblong here, but it should work. It should work. Now, the next thing you need for this is fish bait. Now, any kind of fish can be used for fish bait, which is kind of weird. Use fish to make fish bait. We, however, do have... where's that? Calamari. I do need a piece of string. Oh, we got plenty of calamari. Let's make some more. I should be able to make three. Hold on. Hold on. One, two, three. I need some more string. Okay, so we... fish bait is made like this, and then you put any kind of fish in a section like this, and that makes fish bait. And you get four of them. And then what you do is you come over to your fish trap. And if you've got everything set up right, when you put this in here, it'll start using this and spawn fish in. So I'm just going to let this go, and I'll show you in the next episode. I'm not even going to mess with it. I'm just going to show you. One thing you want, though, is these royal jellies, raw jellyfish right here. Because if you go to uses on those, they give you slime balls, too. So this is another way for you to get the slime balls if you haven't made your mob farm. You can do this. So. And what was the last thing we wanted to do today? I can't remember. No, we did everything we needed to over here. Oh, this is gonna bug me. That's gonna bug me. You guys are gonna scream at me in the comments. That there's gonna be good. Over here we're doing really, really good on this. I did have extra lava in here. I've got these. I kept these here because I might need some more. Netherrack, and I can auto equip these and have them flow in from the sides, I believe, and then drop them into a chest or something to where they'll come out, and then put automatic redstone in here. But right now we're having enough trouble trying to keep up with the power production, so we're not worried about that just yet. Let's go ahead to end the episode off, since I completely forgot what else I wanted to do, is go ahead and make some of this. What did we need for this? Uses. Uses. Shiny. We need one shiny, two tin and one silver. Okay, so tin there, one shiny, one silver. And we can pop up here and pop all four of these in here. We need to make sure these are both on. Okay. And I do have a, still got a little bit of blood in there. That's weird. You know what? I won't let me do that. All right. It's cool. It's cool. So put this, this, and this in there. And it won't take long to actually get up there. And I'll get that blood out of there. I'm guessing it's 160, which means I need to do more like that. Just jump up here and take these out. There we go. Well, now we have some Enderium. Now, what I wanted to do with Enderium, I can't do yet because I need, I believe, 5 for what I wanted to do with them. Resident servos. That sounds pretty good. That's what we want to do with it. All right. This is a thermoelectric generator. It is a passive way of generating electricity. You use a hot liquid and a cold liquid, and the difference in between those two liquids actually produces electricity through this. So I wanted to hook one of these up just to show you guys, because it's pretty cool, and it's completely passive, and that's the only holdup. These are really easy to make. Yeah, just ferrous dust and copper dust. He gives you two. It's not hard to make those. So I'm going to keep up with my stuff over there. I might hook up some kind of automated thing there. I don't know. I would like to get a grinder up over there as soon as possible. But I'll just keep going over there and killing them with my axe. Actually, I'm going to make a weapon. That's what we're going to do. A weapon. I'll do it next time. I'll make sure to make some more Singularum, and we'll make some Singularum weapon of some sort. Anyway, guys, let me put this downstairs. If you like this episode, make sure you smack that like button. If you subscribe to my channel, I'll send you notifications when I have new videos out, and you can check them out and see if you like them. Oh, I remember. Hold up. I remember. Don't scream at me. Let's get you out of my inventory, because if I leave you in there, I'm totally going to be placing you. Where's my dirt? There we go. 2 stacks. Ought to do it. Anyway, if you like this episode, make sure you smack that like button. If you subscribe to my channel, I'll send you notifications when I have new videos out. Why are you not working now? Can you not place dirt? That sucks. We'll see. Okay, so it does have to be... It won't place blocks. It won't place different blocks. So I have to have actually blocks down here. That's kind of weird. I don't use the builder's wand too often, if you can tell. There we go. So... Put a big old line here. There we go. I do want an 8x8, I believe. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I think I'll do one more for 9. And we'll put some lights just randomly. And I'm probably going to need more dirt to complete this. Yeah. Let's go get the rest of that. I can't believe I forgot that I wanted to do the whole animal area. There we go. and then should be able to just, and I'm gonna need some more torches, so I'm gonna go get some of them. One more. Now this should be 9 by 9, and it should be, allow us to put some fences on here. But first things first, we want to put a couple of torches down. How is that for coverage? Looks good for now. I'm gonna put them on the actual fences. So, what kind of fences do we want? I'm guessing, I don't know, what kind of fences do we have available to us? Tons and tons and tons. Treated? They do look good. I don't know. Oh yeah, definitely going with treated because it's going to give us more fences than regular wood. And don't yell at me in the comments. I have tons of creosote. What are you doing? What am I doing? Get out of there. I'm hoping this is probably not going to work. No, I'm going to have to make a regular one. And I bet you that will not link up. I need a fence gate, that's why. And we'll probably go ahead and grab us a pressure plate. And we'll take this over there and put this all the way around the outside of it. And grab us some grass seeds. We get these up and running. Oh, that does look pretty good. I think that looks even better than the dark oak. Should be plenty of fence to cover the whole entire area. And it's actually the first area I've actually fenced up. I've been meaning to fence up the outside of all the rest of this, but just never got around to it. No, I kind of want the fence gate there, if it'll actually work. If not, I'm gonna have to figure something else out. Come on. Please work. Yeah, I mean, you never can tell. Sometimes it will, sometimes it won't. What did I do with it? There it is. And oh, yes. Nice. So, and then we'll put the pressure plate down. Now, that doesn't look right. I know it doesn't, but until I get some a darker looking wood, we'll have to go with that. And we were going to make, let's go ahead and get this grass grown. So we'll put one here, and then we'll put one here, and that'll get started going. And then we'll come over here and grab us some wood. To make some torches. Should do it for now. I'll get the rest of them in a second. Actually, I might need a little bit more than that. Come on. This goes so fast. Anyway, let's go ahead and end this again. If you like this episode, make sure you smack that like button. If you subscribe to my channel, I'll send you notifications when I have new videos out, and you come check them out and see if you like them. If you do like this episode and you want to share it with your friends, tell me what you liked it. There's a share tab down below. Click on the share tab. Copy the link. Post it on your Facebook, Twitter, wherever you do social media. And I will see you guys on the next episode. As soon as I place this... You're being difficult. That should give me plenty. Let's take these out and make sure that this coverage here is actually going to prevent. It's not. Let's put a torch here, and I'll go ahead and put a torch here just so it'll look the same. Sweet. All right, guys. I'll see you guys later.